This here is my very special wireless conducting stick, capable of doing many significant things, such as making the conductor appear invisible to the band's people and ensuring that people who sit next to each other are as out of time as possible. This particular one has an additional feature, and that additional feature is that it can make instruments shrink. This instrument here is a rather old E-flat tuba, and given that I'm only 4'3", it is a beast for me to try and manage, and so I'm going to use my magic wireless conducting stick to shrink it down. So once I utter the special magic words, hocus pocus fortissimosis, you will see that it has turned into this little travel tuba. Returning back to the factual, no-nonsense style that people expect of me, I have to present this. This is the Schiller Travel Tuba. This instrument is in the key of E-flat as it appears now, but you can take out this very twisted, coiled main tuning slide and replace it with a shorter one, and the instrument will play in the key of F. When you have an instrument that has been made as compact as this, you expect to have a few sacrifices, and there are a couple of very key sacrifices that you will make when you want an instrument as small as this. The first downside is that the instrument has got its tubing coiled up much more frequently and much tighter than the bends that you would see on a normal tuba. The result of that is that there is a lot of resistance to putting your ear through this instrument. The instrument is reluctant to have air put through it. And you don't really notice that too much in some of the higher notes, but trying to play anything down low is a real mission. The second downside is that it has this very small bell. Now, it's obviously got a small bell so that it can be portable and all that sort of stuff, but it means that the interface with the ear molecules is much smaller. So the resonance of a tuba is brought about by two things. You've firstly got the fact that the tubing is very conical in nature, so it gradually gets bigger and bigger, and then it has this massive bell out the end. And so the vibration that comes from your lips has all of the surface area with which to vibrate against the surrounding ear molecules. When you make a bell a lot smaller, such as with this, the surface area for the vibrations to impact with the surrounding air molecules is much smaller. So that means that it has less pressure on your eardrums with the vibrations, and you don't feel the vibrations on your body as you may experience if you were playing standing or sitting next to a actual full-size tuba. If you saw one of these and you thought to yourself, well, that's going to be great to have around the home or to take away when I go on holiday or whatever and use as a practice companion, but I don't actually think that that's going to work for you, because the experience of playing this with its resistance and the quirks of the intonation and all of those elements mean that there are very few skills that are going to be transferable from this tuba to a full-size instrument. And so I'm left with this instrument thinking, well, what is it for? What am I going to do with it? And the answer to that is that I'm not 100% sure. I'm thinking that when we play Christmas carols in a small group of, you know, 5 or 6 people, then it might be useful for that, because I'm not going to have to compete as much as far as raw volume is concerned, and it's certainly going to be much more portable and light compared to a full-size instrument. But really, that's about the only thing that I can think of to do with this instrument. If you've got any ideas, then please let me know. But for the rest of this video, I shall let the instrument sounds speak for themselves. Thanks for watching. The book.